Hey guys, this is Brian at OBEDIA, and I'm going to give you an Ableton quick tip today that I hope you'll find useful. And that quick tip is how to back up the ASD files, which hold the warp information for your clips and tracks in Ableton Live. Why would you want to do this? Well, sometimes when you're warping tracks in Ableton, you may have already done a lot of work warping and saved a warped file in Ableton, but you may go back and start making some changes because maybe you're trying to tighten your warping up. Maybe you're working with a track that needs a lot of warping, and you may not want to overwrite all the work that you've done, because what if you get it wrong and now you have to redo all of your work? Well, the simple way to get around that is to back up your ASD files. Now, Ableton does not give you the ability to save multiple ASD files for one track. It saves one ASD file that houses all the warp information for each track or clip that you work with when you're working in Ableton. So if you overwrite the one that you have, all your work is gone. And that is not always what we want, obviously. So let me show you how we can back these files up. I'm working with a clip here in Ableton, of course, and I've just been spending a little bit of time fooling around with the warping. I had previously warped this track a little bit, and I've made some changes now, and what I would like to do is, before I make some further changes and save over my ASD, I want to back up my previous warping. So what I'm going to do is right click on the track that I'm working with, and I'm going to select the option Show in Browser. When I click on Show in Browser, my browser is going to open up on the left hand side of Ableton, and immediately highlighted I'm going to see the file which I'm currently working with. So in this case, it's this MP3 file, and you'll notice that right next to it, it has a little check mark. This means that this file is currently warped. There is an ASD file which accompanies it, which houses my warp information. I want to back that up. So I'm going to right click on this file, and I'm going to scroll down, and I'm on a Mac, I'm going to select Show in Finder. If you're on PC, you're going to select Show in Windows Explorer. Either way, simply click on that, and now you're going to get a Finder or Explorer window, which is going to directly show you the file that you're working with. So right there is the MP3 file that I'm working with, and just below it, you'll notice, is the ASD file. We know it's the Ableton warping file because it has this little check mark in the icon, and of course it ends in the extension .asd. So this is great. This is all I need. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to right-click on this file, and I will select the option Copy. And I'm going to copy this, and what I've done is I've made a folder in my working folder here for my Ableton tracks called ASD Backups. Now all I need to do is paste this item into my folder here, so I've made a copy of it. Now, if I go back into Ableton and I save my warping, which I've done on this track by clicking on Save down here in the Track Inspector, I'm going to overwrite my previous warping settings, which I had done. However, if I find that I don't like what I've done and I want to go back, all I need to do is go back into my Finder, go into my ASD Backups folder, find the ASD file which corresponds to the MP3 or track which I have been working with, go back into my primary working folder which houses that track, and then simply paste that ASD back into this folder. Now, you may need to quit Ableton in order for this to work, because if you try to overwrite a file that's currently in use, such as the ASD file, you may get an error saying you cannot overwrite it. If that ends up happening, all you need to do is quit Ableton and again, just simply paste the ASD file back into the working location, overwrite any current ASD file, and then when you relaunch Ableton Live, the track will now be using your old warping methods, which you had previously saved in an ASD file. So this is a good way to compare, do A-B comparison, switch back and forth and find which warp method you might like more. Or of course, this is another great way to just simply back up your ASD files, which is always a good thing. It's great to keep backups. It doesn't hurt to back up all those files that you have warped so that you don't lose all of your work. So there you go, guys. This is just something that I like to use when I'm warping a lot of tracks and when I'm playing around, especially with tracks that require a lot of attention while warping. I don't like to go back and have to redo a lot of work, so I'll back up my ASD files and just save myself some time. So I hope this saves you guys time, and I hope you enjoyed it. As always, stay in touch with me. My email address is brian@obedia.com, and you can get me on Twitter at twitter.com/obediatutor. And of course on Facebook at facebook.com/OBEDIA tutor. Give me a call, find out how you can work one-on-one with an audio pro like myself. We'll help you to get the most out of your digital audio hardware and software, which is what we do best here at OBEDIA. Thank you guys so much for watching. And until next time, happy music making and take care.